MixCraft 10 comes with a couple of very useful sampler instruments, and those are the Alpha and Omni samplers. So in this video, we're going to look at how to get your audio into them and some of the basics of just getting started using these sampler instruments. So let's dive in. First off, what's the difference between the Alpha and the Omni? Well, with the Alpha, you can load one sample into it. With the Omni, you can have up to 128 samples in there simultaneously. So you can see, we can scroll through here, all the different pages of samples that are available to us. Also, there's two different versions of the Omni sampler. There's just the regular one, or there's the multi-output one, where you can output your pads to different tracks, and we'll get into that in just a bit. But first, how do we get our samples into these? And we're going to start with the Alpha sampler here. So let's just close that down. And there's a few ways that we can do it for both. One of the easier ways is if you already have your clip in the timeline, you could just quickly click on it, drag and drop it into here. And now that clip is loaded in our sampler, and I can easily play that on my MIDI keyboard if I wanted. And with the sampler, you fire that sound, but it goes up and down the keyboard like it's its own instrument, which is kind of neat. So you can create your own cool instruments in here just by recording a sound into the timeline and then dragging that onto here. And away you go. You have your own unique instrument. There's also some tools in here. We have pitch tools. You have your attack and release. You have a low pass filter in there, resonance, a mod wheel. You can have it monophonic. You can loop it. So if I press down here, it's going to continue looping as I hold the key down. There's also reverse in here, so we can click on reverse. And now we've reversed our clip, and then there's lo-fi over here. And that instantly makes whatever clip you have in there a lo-fi sound. So that's pretty cool. And this is your Alpha sampler. Now that was dragging from the timeline. You can also drag from a window or a folder on your computer. You can just drag and drop it in there. Another way we can load them in here is just by clicking on load, and then it brings up your window here and you can find your sample on your computer that way. Or there's even more ways to do this. So let's look at those. And we'll go with this kick example again. So I'll just double click on this. And this is what the whole clip looks like. So there's a bunch of kicks in this one clip. What if I just want one of these? So I could just click and highlight what I want right there. Now I can right click on this selection, go to copy selection 2, and then go Alpha sampler. And now it's created a whole new Alpha sampler with this on there. And it's only this one kick. It's not the whole clip like the other one was the whole clip. This is just the one little part. So you can do that with any sound. It's very easy to do. And that's kind of your basics with the Alpha sampler. It's pretty straightforward, and you can create some cool, unique instruments just by using this one plugin. Now let's look at the Omni sampler. So getting your audio into the Omni sampler is very much the same as we did with the Alpha. We can double click on one of these pads here. So just double click and it's going to bring the add a sound window up where you can browse wherever you have your sounds loaded in that way. You can drag and drop it from the timeline here. So we'll do that. And now we have it loaded in there. And if we wanted, we could drag and drop from a folder on our computer and just drop it into whatever cell you want in here. And you can change up the pages just by clicking over in this area here, but I'll go back to this one. And the Omni sampler that I have loaded up right now, this is just the stereo output. So it just outputs to the one stereo track that it's on. But there is also that multi-output one that we're going to get into in a bit. But you can see over here, you have pretty much all the same controls that you had on the Alpha sampler. It's just laid out a little bit different. But all that stuff is in here. You have the loop, reverse, and lo-fi over here. And this goes per pad. these things here. So if I put lo-fi on C4, it's off on D4. So all of the stuff in here is per pad. And then this section down here is your master section. So this will apply to all of your samples. And again, if we wanted to just take a little part of this, say this part right here, we could right click, copy selection 2. And this time we would choose Omni Sampler, but we can choose the existing Omni Sampler that I have right here. We can choose a new Omni Sampler, and this would be a stereo one or a new multi output one. So you have some options here with the Omni Sampler, but I'm just going to click on this one. And you can see it's loaded it up right next to our other one here. And if we want to get rid of a sound, let's say we want to get rid of this one here, we can just delete selected and then it's gone. We can also rename these. So if you right click on it, you can see rename. So if you wanted to give each one a custom name, you could do that. But right now I want to load a snare into here. So we have two different things. So now we have a kick and snare. So I could easily start playing that. And I've created my own custom drum kit from two different loops. And I can continue to do this and add drums in there, but maybe I don't like the keys that the snare is on anyway. So I could easily move this over by clicking and dragging, then letting go onto whatever pad I want. Now, what I want to do is show you the multi-output version. And this time I'm going to copy selection 2, Omni Sampler, new multi-out. All right, so we have our kick right there. Now let's get our snare drum. So again, I'm going to copy selection. This time I'm going to go to 8 out, which is our multi-out one. And now if I look up here in our track list, you can see I have Omni Sampler 8. And of course I can give this a different name if I wanted just by double clicking there. And we'll call this Multi Omni. So I'll right click on that. We have our kick and snare in here. I want to put snare over on D4, kicks right here. And what's the difference between this multi output one and the other one? We now have this output section right here. So kick. Yeah, we'll have kick output to 1, then snare, let's output that to 2. And if we go over here, you can see there's this plus sign. Let's click on that. And these are all the child tracks, as they call it, for the multi-omni sampler. And here's output 1, which will be our kick. You see that's on there. Now, if we press the snare, that's outputting to 2, and we can continue to do that. It has 8 outputs in it. This can be really helpful if you are creating a drum kit in here and you want to put a different compressor and EQ just on the kick drum and just on the snare and whatever elements you have for your drum kit. This allows you to do that. Or if you have different types of instruments loaded up, you can have them output to different tracks. There's lots of versatility with the Omni Sampler, and I'm going to show you another way that we can work with it. So down here, I have this drum loop, and it's all of our drums put together. So it's a complete drum kit on one file. Let's double click on that. And this time I want to go to Slice 2. So I'm going to click Slice 2, and we can slice by beats or measures. I'm going to choose beats. And in here, you can choose half notes, quarter notes, eighth notes, and whatever you want in here. I'm going to choose eighth notes for now. And then you can choose where you want to start it. I'm going to start this at, say, C3. And then we have some other options in here. So no slices before measure 1 if you want. Confined to loop area. So if we had a loop area selected, we could just confine it to chop that up. Create a MIDI clip, and I'm going to do that to show you what that is. And then you can load this to the performance panel, which we'll get into in a different video, load it to a different track, but we're loading this to the Omni Sampler. And I want it to a new one, but I want it to a multi-output one. You could also load this to an existing one, but I want a new multi-output one. And you can see this says it's going to create 32 slices. So let's click on OK. And now it's loaded all of our slices into here, and we can start playing them. So you can start to have some fun with that and start renaming things or taking parts out that you don't want. Or you could go back and choose to slice this up in a different way. But what I want to show you right now is this MIDI clip that is created. So here's the MIDI clip, and I'm just going to solo our Omni track, play this back. So this MIDI clip is playing all of those little slices back to back to back, and it's put it into a nice MIDI clip that you can edit. It's kind of a cool thing to have MIDI control over a drum loop or any loop, because it allows you to really mangle things up or create your own sound with it. And this exists as MIDI only, so we don't even need that drum loop anymore, because everything's loaded into our Omni sampler. It just allows for a whole lot more creativity, or you can use something like this to go behind your drum track. So maybe you have an existing drum track that you like and you just want to thicken things up a bit. You can load that up into the sampler here and maybe even replace some of the samples with a different kick or a different snare. And that's just going to thicken up your existing drum track. There's lots of different ways you can use this Omni sampler and the Alpha sampler. Now, in the next video, we're going to look at Melodyne that comes with the Pro Studio version.